عليه وسلم أحمد بن مبي there in the in the in 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 يوم القيامة. He said he would go straight to Ahmad Ubamba. Now, can you convince this individual? Do you think this individual have doubts about what he is upon? Do you think that his individual will be going to Salah and say, Oh Allah, aid me to get out of this Muridiyya, this Sufiyya. A person might be smoking. Say, Oh Allah, help me to stop smoking. Oh Allah, I'm struggling with music. Help me to get out of it. Oh Allah, I'm struggling with this and the third. Help me to get out of it. A person will say this because they don't want to be part of that. They might be struggling to be doing it. But this individual, he want to die upon that. To the point that the other one, he say, Allahu Akbar. The other Tijani, he say, right? He say, Yawm al-Qiyamati. If Allah will give me anything and he does not give it to me by way of his sheikh, he say, I don't want it. Abdullah, you think in Sierra Leone you have foolishness? Welcome to Senegal. He say, if Yawm al-Qiyamati, if Yawm al-Qiyamati Allah will reward me of anything or give me anything and he doesn't give it to me by way of he name his sheikh, he say, I don't want it. Now look at the arrogance in it. I don't want it. If Allah gonna give me the Jannah and he doesn't give it to me by, let's say he will give the keys of my apartment in the Jannah, he will give it to the sheikh and the sheikh will give it to me, I want it. You don't think that is compounded misguidance? You don't think that it is foul misguidance? Stinking misguidance? A person will think lowly of Allah like this. You will think lowly of Allah like this. Akhi, if you were to be doing a test or passing an exam and you happen to be the first one, you want your prize to be given by the highest authority. Right? You want your prize to be your certificate or your diploma to be given by the highest, right? The highest of the ranks. You don't want the individual broom in the director's office to be giving your diploma while the minister is sitting there. Somebody call the Iqam at the Adhan.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Where is drama? شفاه الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله
أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا على الصلاة
حول قوة الله
هيا على الصلاة
حول قوة الله
هيا على الفلاة هيا على الفلاة
حرق وطن
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
على الله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وسلم اللهم رب العالمين شفاك الله اللهم رب هذه دعوة والصلاة القائمة على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي هو الذي So he mentioned that the people of the Sunnah, they refuted them bihujajin wa barahin min kitabillahi wa sunnati rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have indeed refuted the people of innovation in regard to their innovations by way of the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with crystal clear evidences. Crystal clear evidences. وممن رد عليهم الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله. And from those that has refuted them is Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, the student of who was the major teacher of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. Who was the major teacher of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim? Ustaz Bukhari. Bukhari. You fell off your sleep or something? Tunkara. Who was the major teacher of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah? Ustaz, I'm going to take the title Ustaz from you. Oh, he gave it to you? Oh, man.
I gave it to you.
Oh, no, I'm going to give it to you. Huh? Huh? Oh, skip, huh? Okay, all right. Abba Ibrahim? Abdullah? Abba Ahmed? Ahsanta Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah. Very good. Ibn Taymiyyah. So if you have your book where he say waqad wa mimman radda alayhim Imam Ibn Qayyim, so you put a note on the side, ahadu talamiz Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, ahadu talamiz Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, right? One of the major students of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, and they will call him Shaykh al-Islam al-Thani, the second Shaykh al-Islam, meaning Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. Right? Ahsan. Al-Hujaj. Al-Hujaj is the hujjah, the evidences. Wal-Barahin. Right? That's the same word. The Barahin as the Burhan. Right? The Burhan. Right? Al-Burhan. Bima'ana the clear evidences. Al-Hujaj. Are those barakallahu fikum evidences, and the barahin, that's the same thing. Yani the hujjah, right? The what you call it, the proofs and evidences. Barakallahu fikum. The proofs and evidences. So he mentioned ihtajja Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah bi sab'i ayat min al-Quran. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he has taken 7 verses in the Quran. 7 verses. In the Quran. طيب. And if you look at it, he mentioned قد يستبعد الإنسان الاستدلال بها, that by way of those 7 verses a person might not get that this is a proof to show that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be seen يوم القيامة. He says 7 verses that a person will look into or will read it in the Quran, in the Sunnah. But he will not get that this is what? This is barakallahu fik, a proof to establish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sawfa yura, that Allah will be seen yawm al-qiyamati in the Jannah. Right? Walakin idha ta'ammalaha yajid annahu ala sawab fi istidlali biha rahimahullah. But if you look into those 7 verses, that you will realize barakallahu fikum, that indeed they are the proofs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be seen yawm al-qiyamati. Minha, from them, qawlullah tabaraka wa ta'ala, from those verses. How many verses? 7. From those verses. So if those verses matter, me and you will look at it, we might not see that it is a proof for what? That Allah will be seen. But he say, "Law idh," he say, "Walakin idha ta'ammalaha," that if the person will contemplate in it, examine it closely, that he will be deriving with correctness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be seen yawm al-qiyamati. And that's why it is important to refer the matters of the deen to who? To the scholars. Don't just read the Quran because you can read or you have a good Arabic and then you want to read it and then derive your own ruling or your own istinbat. Just because you can read it, okay, Alif Bata, you put it together just because, and that you want to place your own istinbat, your own rulings, and you're extracting your own issues. But rather, it is not so. But the matter has to go back to the scholars. The matter has to go back to the scholars. And the scholars are not, let's say you will have individual, they will quote you Ibn Qayyim all day long. You got the likes of Dawood Bojan, he will quote you Ibn Qayyim all day long. But he will surround himself with Sufi. He will surround himself with Tijani. He will surround himself with the likes of these individuals. Now where is the Ibn al-Qayyim standing? Akhi, the matter here, it is not about, people are not being judged by what they say, but rather by their actions. They are held accountable by their actions. They are being looked at what they do, not only what you say, but what you do. You say, Qala Ibn Qayyim and the likes of this, but your surrounding, they all Sufi and Tijani. Known. And you have never ever refuted any of them. You never ever refuted any of them. Or if you do, you will not do it in front of them. Never ever refuted a Tijani. But rather, you're going to be mixing with them, mingling with them. Some from them, minha from it, is qawlullah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The statement of Allah that could be found in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 223. He say, "Inna annakum mulaqu, annakum mulaqu, annakum mulaqu," that you will meet him. That you will meet him. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he say, "Wal-liqa," meeting. Al-liqa, meeting. He say, "La budda fihi min ru'ya." It is a must that the person, when you say, "I will meet you tomorrow," barakallahu fikum, that doesn't mean I will call you tomorrow. That doesn't mean I will send you a text message tomorrow. That doesn't mean I will send you a telegraph for those times. That doesn't mean I will write you a letter. That is not the meaning of "I will meet you." Al-liqa, meeting. It is a must that the person, barakallahu fikum, has to have what? A physical sight with that which he's, or that, the one that he's meeting. Wal mu'ayana, and likewise, barakallahu fikum, that physical, yani, that they will have between them. And he said, "Wa hada ma taqtadihi al-lugha," and this is that which is the guidelines or that implies in the Arabic language. And in any other language, in English, when you say, "I will meet you tomorrow at 5 o'clock at Aldi," does it mean I'm going to send you a text up there? Does it mean I will send somebody up there? No, you say, "I will meet you." So that physical sight, that physical encounter is there, is going to be there. How old are you, Muhammad? Huh? Open your mouth and speak louder. 13? You're acting like a 5 years old. Abdurrahman is acting better than you. So this is in the lugha, barakallahu fikum. Alaykum salam. He say, "Wahtajja aydan," and likewise, Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he has also made a mention and use it as a proof and evidence. In that which he say, "Inna al-aya allati yata'allaq biha alladhina yunkiruna ru'yatillah mithlu qawlillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala la tudrikuhu al-absar wa huwa yudrikuhu wa huwa yudrikul absar wa huwa al-latiful khabir." He say, naqala shaykh al-islam ibn taymiyyah rahimahullah tabaraka wa ta'ala, "Anna Allah la tamdah bi mujarradati nafi." A very important point right here. And likewise, from those verses, that the individual that are using, like the Mu'tazila, using it to derive that Allah would not be seen yawm al-qiyamati, it is one of these verses, barakallahu fikum. This verse, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-An'am, verse 103, he say, "La tudrikuhu al-absaru." The eyesight will not encompass him. The eyesight will not encompass him. meaning Allah. وَهُوَ يُدْرِكُهُ الْأَبْصَارِ